Good evening, and welcome to Arlington County's 49th annual tribute to Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr. Tonight's program was developed by Ann Smith, produced by Charles Hawkins, with musical direction by Monique Holmes Spells. Thank you.
On Tuesday, January 15, 1929, at the family home in Atlanta, Georgia, a baby boy was born to Reverend Michael King and his school teacher wife, Alberta Christine. The boy, Michael Jr., lived with his parents, grandparents, and his two siblings, Christine and Alfred Daniel, AD. Michael, the middle child, was special from the beginning. He loved people and he loved to learn. Young Michael also loved and revered his father. That love shaped and modeled young Michael in many ways, and that special love of his father was of a man affectionately known as Daddy King. During a visit to Berlin in 1934, Daddy King began to reflect on the teachings and the writings of Martin Luther, the great Protestant reformer. He came back to Atlanta a changed man. To show his commitment to that change, he changed his name and that of his son. From that time on, these men were to be known respectively as Reverend Martin Luther King Sr. and his son, Martin Luther King Jr.
Young Martin grew up in a happy upper middle class home. His parents were very influential in the community, were very active members of the civil rights community, and not afraid to take a stand for what was right. Young Martin learned from his parents to follow his conscience and to fight for what he believed in.
My brother, for someone who couldn't say a word, my brother said everything. Born blind, unable to walk, talk, swallow, or move any part of his body, Noah's life was a struggle. He was in constant pain and often in hospital, but he never complained, ever. Wherever we went, people would stare. But to me, he was just my amazing brother. At 13, suddenly, he died. I was 8. Shocked, sad, lonely. It was right at that moment I realized Noah did say something to me. He told me to always live life to the fullest. Be strong, even when something is hard. And be different. Don't just be normal, stand out. My brother didn't need words to inspire me. Thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy, for showing us all that the dream is still alive and well. Always curious and interested in the world around him, Martin excelled in school. At the age of 15, he graduated from high school and entered Morehouse College. He graduated from Morehouse with a degree in sociology, but answering the call to ministry at the age of 18, he entered the Crozer Theological Seminary, where he earned a Bachelor of Divinity degree in 1951. Reverend King became Dr. King in 1955 when he earned his PhD in systematic theology from Boston University. While at Boston, he gained a reputation as a great orator and as a great ladies' man. He also gained the attention of a young music student from Alabama, Coretta Scott.
Pick me up the hill, there's no looking. my best, standing by you like a tree, daring anybody to try and move me on.
Telling you I found strength when I was torn down. Don't know what's in store. Together we can open any door. Just to do what's good for you.
Come on, darling.
And inspire you a little higher.
I know you can make a man out of a soul that didn't ever go.
Cause we got the right foundation.
Humiliation, beatings, bombings, jail, dogs, fire, clubs, ropes.
Across the country for his oratory skills and his commitment to the philosophy of nonviolence. Rooted in the teachings of Mahatma Gandhi and Jesus Christ, King was committed to achieving social change through nonviolent methods. In June of 1960, I joined the Howard students for the Arlington sit-ins. Arlington is my hometown. I'd been arrested twice in the Durham, North Carolina sit-ins, so I was a bit of an asset. The first day, we started at People's on Lee Highway and moved on to the Cherrydale Drug Fair. Then came Shirlington and Buckingham, before we took a break. There were no arrests, but the Nazis turned out to heckle and picket us. Some customers voiced their support and even joined us. When we sat in again a week later, we were served. The prosecuting attorney had decided not to enforce the public assembly law. Gandhian nonviolence won again. Nobody could turn us around.
Turn me You're broken down and tired of living life on the merry-go-round. And you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move.
Many of the younger members in the community and in the movement began to question Dr. King and his beliefs. Other militant factions began to lean towards the approach of an eye for an eye. Reverend King was criticized and betrayed by those that he had once called his friends. This was not the first time he had been criticized or his message questioned. But standing fast in his faith, Reverend King continued down the path he had chosen.
Lord, take my hand and lead me on. Help me stand. I am tired. And I am worn through the storm, through the night. Lead me on to the light. And take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me home. When my way grows Lord, linger near when my life is almost gone. Lest I fall and take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me home. When darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone, Lord, at the river I stand, guide my feet and hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me home. Please take my hand, precious Lord. Home, lead me.
What is it, Martin? I'll say it again. What is it, Martin? Is this educated Kizzy supposed to be blind? Stevie don't wonder why you can't see. Your degrees will not save you. Your proper English does not make you unlynchable. Your use of pronouns are not so profound that you can't become strange fruit. We stood. As slaves, we stood, and we're standing today. When we were spit on for trying to go to school, we stood. When Emmett Till was lynched, we stood. When those four black girls were bombed, when the water hose were used as we walked on sidewalks, when we tried to vote, when we tried to sit at a counter, we stood. Well, isn't it their turn to look around? How much blood must we stand in before they look down? We fought and died in wars. We fought under that red, white, and blue flag and all it represents. Yet, we were disrespected, treated like lepers, segregated and isolated. We're sick of singing America the Beautiful. Why don't we sing the third verse of the Star Spangled Banner instead? The Statue of Liberty has more liberty than we do. Martin, don't you get it? Oh, say, can you see? We wait for approval. We wait to be approved for which protests we can do, which march we can do, what we can say. By the way, if you can tell me how to protest, I'm not protesting, I'm conforming. Our cause will not be blinded by other people's words. Don't you hear the hypocrisy in your hypocrisy? Some of you would have even given Gandhi instructions on his hunger strike. Gandhi, please eat. Don't not eat because you're disrespecting our food. Martin, aren't you looking? Some people want an eye for an eye and want to fight fire with gasoline. Hate may not drown out hate, but we're sick of dying politely. Our only dilemma is on freedom. Does it have to be given? Or can we take it? Can we keep waiting for our worth to become clear to someone who doesn't use their eyesight to see our vision? Our cause is lost, lost into misinterpreted words. Our lost and found is full of discounted concerns and overlooked pain. We just want freedom. We just want to break the chains that bind, but you keep adding more links. J. Cole said it best. All we want to do is break the chains off. All we want to do is be free. We sick of gargling with someone else's spit. We want to write our own lyrics. All we want to do is break the chains off. All we want to do is be free, free. Free. We are black butterflies trying to get you to see that we have wings. When a flower dies, the whole forest cries. They don't check on the color of the flower.
Sometimes I feel like a moth.
Sometimes I feel
Sometimes come on home, like come on home. I'm missing. miss you, child, but I'm a long way.
Sometimes I feel like
from a home,
a long way from home. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child.
Good evening. I have the honor and the privilege of sharing a passage of Dr. Martin Luther King's Jr. iconic sermon, The Drum Major. Yes, if you want to say that I was a drum major, say that I was a drum major for justice. Say that I was a drum major for peace. I was a drum major for righteousness. And all of the other shallow things will not matter. I won't have any money to leave behind. I won't have the fine and luxurious things of life to leave behind. But I just want to leave a committed life behind. And that's all I want to say. If I can help somebody as I pass along, if I can cheer somebody with a word or a song, if I can show somebody he's traveling wrong, then my living will not be in vain. If I can do my duty as a Christian ought, if I can bring salvation to a world once wrought, if I can spread the message as the master taught, then my living will not be in vain. Yes, Jesus, I want to be on your right or on your left side, not for any selfish reason. I want to be on your right or your left side, not in terms of some political kingdom or ambition, but I just want to be there in love, in justice, and in truth. Thank you, and good evening.
Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. I've decided to stick with love. Hate is too great a burden to bear. We are here today to celebrate the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who through his nonviolent leadership and actions brought us closer together and closer to his philosophy of living in peace and love. Dr. King had a dream, a powerful dream. So, as we leave here today, let us live our lives in peace, love, and respect for our fellow man, living to the fullest and doing our best to keep the dream alive.
Of our Christ's heart is come.
Thank you for joining us this evening to honor Dr. King.